जो भी गुनहगार है उन्हें उनके किए की सजा अवश्य मिलेगी।
अगर आप ये समझते हैं कि आप पाकिस्तान के ऊपर कुछ किसी किस्म का हमला करेंगे, पाकिस्तान रिटेलिएट करेगा।
इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान आर लॉक्ड इन अ फियर्स डिप्लोमेटिक वॉर, स्पेशली आफ्टर द रीसेंट पुलवामा अटैक दैट हैज हैपेंड। विद द कुलभूषण जाधव हियरिंग एट द इंटरनेशनल कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस एट द फाइनल स्टेज, व्हाट इज इट व्हिच इज एट स्टेक फॉर इंडिया? The case is very critical to the perception management for both countries, and especially India, keeping in mind that our country has repeatedly cited that Pakistan has violated the due process. All of this needs to be carefully argued before the International Court of Justice, and that is why Harish Salve, the ace lawyer representing the Indian government, has cited that Pakistan is in violation of the Vienna Convention, to which it is a signatory, and also the due process, which is the fundamental requirement in law. Those laws have not been followed with the military court establishment in the state of Pakistan. On the other hand, Pakistan has said that Kulbhushan Jadav is an Indian spy conspiring against the state of Pakistan. This victory is very critical to India's interests at the diplomatic stage, and also the repeated denial of Pakistan for consular access to Kulbhushan Jadav. That is one of the key arguments that India has in defense of Kulbhushan Jadav. But what can the ICJ do? What are its powers and what is the ambit? The International Court of Justice has wide powers to adjudicate on matters of key importance. Usually it has advisory and also jurisdiction to look at the disputes which are brought by two warring countries or two countries in dispute. It is the consent of these two sovereign nations that the ICJ goes ahead and begins hearing in a matter. In most instances, like the Kulbhushan Jadav case, the ICJ has asked the country, one of the countries which is at the heart of the dispute, to review and reconsider its decision, while India is seeking an immediate release of Kulbhushan Jadav. So clearly, there is some amount of conflict and some amount of vagueness to what the ICJ can actually do. Can the International Court of Justice actually implement the judgment it gives? Well, mostly the countries which are signatory to the required conventions have complied with the orders of the International Court of Justice, keeping the international traditions and conventions in mind. ICJ relies on soft power of the moral force and also the diplomatic pressure that eventually builds up to implement its verdict. So it really remains to be seen what is the logical conclusion which is going to come out of this. But clearly, as experts point out, this victory would be very critical to India's perception management at the world diplomatic stage.